Hello and welcome to this module, in which we'll examine what citywide inclusive sanitation is and how it's linked to broader urban management. We'll look at the need for integrated urban sanitary services, three major technical challenges for serving poor communities, why a mix of sewered and non-sewered sanitation is needed, and components of the new urban sanitation agenda. The left side of the diagram shows five basic urban sanitary services: solid waste, stormwater drainage, latrines, septic tanks, and sewerage. Each has a safe service chain, which is illustrated from left to right by the green arrows. The delivery of these services to households is constrained by the way land is managed and owned. For example, is there road access for the removal of solid waste, faecal sludge, and septage? Is there frequent flooding due to runoff from built-up areas and the occupation of natural drainage channels and buffer zones? Are many dwellings rented so that tenants have no motive to invest in making a sewer connection or building a pit latrine? Is there enough space on a plot for a septic tank and soakaway? The right side of the diagram shows downstream treatment and disposal facilities. These are also constrained by physical planning and land use control. For example, has land been allocated for sanitary landfill and faecal waste treatment facilities? Is it near enough to be viable for service providers without being too close to local residents? Are treated end products at an economically viable distance from their potential markets? But in practice, the safe service chains often break down or are simply not there. Latrines and septic tanks often overflow, deliberately or not, into the surface drainage system. Fecal waste may be dumped into the drainage system by unscrupulous operators or overflow from sewers and broken-down pumping stations. And the drainage system itself may be blocked by uncollected solid waste. The net result of all this is fecally contaminated water flowing through the urban area, often overflowing and spreading disease to citizens, and polluting rivers and land downstream. Poorly maintained and operated treatment facilities and leachate from landfill sites add further to the downstream pollution. This is a faecal waste flow diagram, or SFD. Along the top is the generic sanitation service chain. The red arrows on the left represent the flow of faecal waste split up between the various types of toilets used by the city's population. The width of the arrows is proportional to the number of people whose waste follows each route. The green horizontal arrows represent safely managed fecal waste, and the red ones unsafely managed waste. As each waste stream flows from left to right, the fecal waste is either safely managed or escapes into the environment. Open defecation and unsafely built toilets tend to pollute the immediate residential environment. This is most common in areas of high density or low-cost rented housing, and where people are living in challenging circumstances, such as above water or in flood-prone areas. Where there are improved toilets, fecal waste may still be unsafely emptied by manual emptiers or unregulated tankers, and then discharged indiscriminately. Sewers and pumping stations may also overflow. These flows mostly contaminate the drainage system. Further downstream, fecal sludge and sewage treatment is often inadequate and contaminates the receiving waters. The major challenges typically highlighted by an SFD fall into three main areas: poorly functioning sewage systems and low connection rates, inadequate fecal sludge management from unhygienic toilets, to unsafe emptying, to open dumping, to ineffective treatment, as shown on these photos. The third major challenge is open defecation and unsafe toilets in high-density and low-income areas or challenging environments, which are often occupied by informal settlements. These are difficult challenges, but they can and must be addressed. Some possible approaches are listed here. Where sewerage systems exist, they can often have more impact by increasing connections to existing sewers and extending the system or building decentralized systems to reach poor and unconnected customers. Fecal sludge management can be improved through better on-site toilets and by more hygienic emptying, transport, and treatment of fecal waste. Where there is rental housing and informal settlements, it may be necessary to consider shared toilets and other solutions for limited space. This could include container-based systems and financing arrangements to facilitate improvements for tenants. In challenging environments, such as where housing is located in swamps and high groundwater areas, or on stilts above rivers, lakes, or sea, on rocky terrain or steep hillsides, or in cold climates, different solutions are often needed. The current mix of sanitation technologies used varies greatly across continents and countries. This chart shows just how much. For example, look at sub-Saharan and northern Africa and southern Asia, which have 10%, 90%, and 30% sewerage, respectively. Future sanitation solutions will be equally diverse, with each country looking for the best path to improve sanitation services incrementally from their current reality. A single technology will never be able to provide services for the wide variety of urban environment. Sewerage is well suited to densely occupied areas like the central business district or medium to high density housing. But it requires major infrastructure investments, a good water supply, and definitive land tenure. In comparison, non-sewered sanitation is more flexible and can be implemented or substituted easily and quickly. It's well suited to rapidly changing and unplanned areas, as well as low-density, high-income housing. The citywide sanitation agenda includes sewered and non-sewered services. Addressing this agenda will include expanding and improving the effectiveness of sewage systems, making more sewage connections, including for poor customers, delivering improved toilets at scale for those who lack them, and developing sanitation solutions for rented accommodation and challenging environments, establishing viable, affordable faecal sludge management systems, and increasing the recovery of nutrients, water, and energy from processed faecal waste. In summary, sanitation services are more effective when integrated with water supply, drainage, and solid waste management. The major challenges are to increase the use of sewage systems, improve faecal sludge management, and deliver sanitation to low-income rental accommodation and in challenging environments. Citywide inclusive sanitation addresses both non-sewered and sewered services, and especially services which have been largely neglected in the past. Thank you for listening.